Hi, I'm Vicky Ruffing. I am the Director of Patient Education at the Johns Hopkins Arthritis Center.
And my name is Dr. Rebecca Manno. I'm an assistant professor of medicine at the Johns Hopkins Division of Rheumatology in the Johns Hopkins Arthritis Center. Welcome to part two of frequently asked questions about corticosteroids.
Our first question is, I'm going on vacation. What if I run out of my prednisone?
Whenever preparing for travel, it is important to talk to your doctor about having an adequate supply of all of your medications, but especially your corticosteroid or your prednisone. You may want to ask your doctor for a vacation supply just in case something happens to your medication during your travels. But sometimes things happen. Maybe your luggage gets lost or you miscounted how many steroid or prednisone tablets that you have. If you do run out of your prednisone, call your doctor immediately. They can usually refill your prescription at a local pharmacy. As we discussed in part one of frequently asked questions, it is important that you don't stop your prednisone suddenly. If you do miss a dose, take your next dose at the time it is normally prescribed.
Our next question is about vaccinations. If I'm going to get a vaccine, is that safe while I'm on prednisone?
Vaccinations are incredibly important for all of our patients who are on immunosuppression. Vaccines can protect against very vicious viruses and infections that can cause a lot of problems. If you're on prednisone and you're receiving a vaccine, you need to know if the vaccine is a live vaccine or a killed or an inactivated vaccine. Some live vaccines may not be appropriate while on immunosuppression, and specifically high doses of prednisone. Vicky, how do you counsel patients on the flu vaccine while on prednisone?
Well, of course, we encourage all patients to get the flu vaccine, as well as the pneumonia vaccine. Now, the flu vaccine does not cause the flu. It is not a live vaccine. It is a synthetic, vaccine against the flu. We do not see patients come down with the flu if they've gotten a vaccine. I just can't stress enough how important it is for our patients to get the flu vaccine just so that they can help boost their immunity and their resistance against flu, which of course can be deadly.
That's great advice, Vicky. So a scenario that comes up quite frequently, Vicky, especially among my patients who have been on prednisone for a long period of time, maybe for conditions such as polymyalgia rheumatica or rheumatoid arthritis or giant cell arteritis, and they've been slowly tapered off the prednisone, maybe over a course of months or even years. So they're off prednisone, but then something new happens. For example, they get poison ivy, or they have a terrible asthma attack, and their doctor recommends a short course of prednisone to treat a different condition. This can cause some stress, anxiety, and a lot of questions for patients. How do you counsel patients in this situation?
Well, naturally, I think that patients are afraid that they'll be tied to their prednisone again, where they may have to have that long period of months to taper off. So it's a natural concern for patients to have. However, what I like to tell patients is that when we want to use prednisone in a short burst, it's for a specific reason and there is a time limit to it. So a patient's going to start it and complete it within 2 weeks to a month. So it starts high with higher dose and then tapers down quickly. So you do not see that prolonged taper that's needed when patients have been taking prednisone for a long period of time. It's important to treat whatever the condition is that's requiring that short burst of prednisone. So we need to weigh risk and benefit, and it's definitely more on the benefit side to go with that short burst of prednisone.
I absolutely agree, Vicky. And it gets back to a point we made in one of the earlier videos about whenever prednisone or a steroid is being prescribed, as a patient, it's important to discuss with your doctor what is the dose, what is the indication, what is the duration, and what can I expect?